Queridos amigos, welcome back. How you doing, my friend? This is your program, When I Grew Up, I Want to Be. Cuando yo crezca, quiero ser. With you truthfully, la abuela Tomasa, que está aquí siempre de metiche preguntando cosas para ustedes. Today we have something special. We have a special person who is going to tell us more about opera. No, don't worry. Relax. I'm not going to sing. Now, but maybe some of you, my little ones, have boys and they say, oh, I'm going to sing. It's not just like that. It's not that I have a little voice and I'm going to start singing. No. Today we have a professional who is who works in Opera Memphis. I'm going to introduce you. Les voy a presentar a Betania Baray. ¿Dije correcto el apellido? ¿Baray? Sí, ¿verdad? ¡Baray!
Miren, hasta el nombre tiene bonito, mi hijita. Chula, ¿cómo estás, nietecita mía? ¿Cómo te va?
Muy bien, abuela Tomasa. Gracias por tenerme aquí. Thank you for having me, abuela.
Thank you for taking the time to talk to us and let all these little ones who are still looking what to do when they grow up. They tienen una opción, okay? All right. My first question. It may be easy because sometimes, like I say it before, muchos niños tienen una voz angelical. Yo canto y me mandan a la ambulancia. Piensan que tengo. Entonces, a veces siempre voy a cantar. Pero una persona, por ejemplo, tú, ¿a qué edad dijiste, creo que voy a utilizar mi voz para hacer algo bonito y muy bueno? How old you were?
Well, that's a tough question to answer, only because I used to sing at church, and we used to sing church music. Yeah, so I sang in church, yo canté en la iglesia, así empecé cantando, pero cuando fui como a, yo creo, la middle school o la high school, es cuando dije, se me hace que yo canto bien. Pero,
no sé por qué, I got the feeling there.
Yeah. Exactly. So I started getting really involved in choir when I was in high school. And that's when I found out about opera and about singing in choirs and classical music. And that's when I fell in love with singing.
Okay. Wow. Now this is something really important because you find out that you have a nice voice, but it's not just have a nice voice. You have to educate that beautiful voice. ¿Estoy correcto o no? Tienes que educar la voz, no es nada más sacar el gorgoreo, es tener, ustedes saben, many kids might say, no, I don't have to go to school. Let's see what Betania has to say.
Sí, abuela, yo la verdad es que no, bueno, tenía bonita voz, pero tú no naces con una voz de ópera, ¿verdad? Nadie nace cantando ópera. Es algo que tienes que estudiar. Y se estudia como por 10 años. Y hasta es 10 años para ser una profesional de ópera. Mucho estudio.
Vean nada más, 10 años para tener una voz de ópera y cantar Otelo.
No, yo no sé Otelo eso.
Digo, yo no puedo. No. Oye, I like that you say that, but because many kids might think, nah, you're just gonna sing, and I might sing opera too. But you have to have years of practice and education. So,
exacto. Porque la ópera es, cantas y no tienes micrófono. Así que tienes que entrenar tu voz para aprender cómo usar la breath, usar tu, ¿cómo se dice breath?
O cuando respiras, la respiración.
Tienes que, ajá, entonces te enseñan todos los músculos, cómo trabaja todo eso para que puedas cantar en un auditorio y que todos te puedan escuchar sobre una orquesta de como 50 músicos que están en la orquesta.
¿Ya vieron? Ellos no usan micrófono. Por eso tienen que usar su sistema respiratorio para ayudarse a sacar
la voz de por dentro.
Ay, no, ¿qué voz es eso que tiene la abuelita? Bueno, estos son years and years that you have to practice and study and educate. Si un joven ahora, ¿cuál sería tu recomendación para ese joven que dice, bueno, es que yo sí quiero cantar ópera, a mí sí me gusta, o sea, canto rancheras, le canto el Happy Birthday a mi mamá, pero este, la música me gusta, porque hay muchos niños por ahí que lo escuchan y dicen, sí, sí me gustó la ópera. Y va a haber otros que dicen, no, prefiero reggaetón. No, niños, eso no, reggaetón no, ¿eh?
A mí me encanta el reggaetón, la verdad. Perdón. Perdón, okay. abuela, no, pero mira, me encantan muchos tipos de música, pero la ópera me encanta. Pero cuando estaba chiquita, yo no sabía nada de la ópera, así que fui a mi primera ópera en el colegio, y entonces es cuando dije, oh my God, yo tengo que cantar así. Pero se me olvidó tu pregunta.
¿Cuál sería tu consejo? What can you tell a kid who wants to follow your steps, who wants to pursue this career? Because it's a career. It's una profesión.
Yeah, so if you enjoy singing and if you're young, I would actually surprisingly suggest for you to take piano lessons. And that's where I would start. I know it sounds weird. Rather than taking voice lessons, I would start with piano lessons because that teaches you how to train your ear and how to read music. Reading music is a very important skill that you need to be an opera singer. And the better of a musician you are, the easier it will be later on to become an opera singer.
I didn't know that about you need to read music. Okay? Yeah. Leo las recetas de cocina, pero leer música, no sabía que tenían que leer, que saber. Y eso de tocar piano primero antes de tomar una clase de voz.
Ooh. Sí, porque la voz de alguien joven es muy tierna todavía, ¿verdad? Entonces no es hasta que ya están más grandes que pueden entrenar bien para cantar ópera, porque si empiezas a cantar así desde pequeño te puedes dañar, así que es mejor tenerlos to improve your skills as a musician. Uh-huh. Music and learning how to play piano or another instrument, and that would probably be better to start with. And then later on, when you're, I don't know, 15, to take voice lessons.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, my friend, there it is. Now, tell me something. What is the best part of being an opera singer? What is the thing that you enjoy that you say, oh, this is why I'm doing this, and this is why I get involved with opera? Because you can get involved in that without even singing, doing more stuff behind the scenes, okay? But what is it you do that you say, yes, this is what I love to do?
Yeah, well, aside from loving the music, I like my job because of the people that it allows me to work with. I get to meet a lot of different people and people that are different than me. And I think that the most beautiful thing about working in the arts is that you get to meet and create with people of different backgrounds, different cultures, and you get to learn and celebrate your differences while you still see the similarities of people. And the arts helps you see that, and that's why I love my job.
Oh, okay. I like that that you have chances to do more. Now, here's the thing. Maybe you don't know. If you don't know, you will know it right now. Opera es en italiano, la mayoría de las canciones. ¿Está correcto? La mayoría de las óperas son en italiano. You don't have to understand italiano to understand the opera. But here comes my question. You have to learn another language.
Absolutely. So whenever you go to study a vocal performance or opera in college, you take diction classes that teach you how to pronounce a lot of languages, Italian, French, German, and Latin. And so then in grad school, you take these languages and you take about a year or two of these languages. So it's very important to learn your languages, but also if you go to an opera, you don't need to know these languages. You will be able to see those super titles on top of the stage that translate for you. And so it's kind of like watching a movie, a foreign movie, rather than seeing the subtitles, you see the surtitles.
You have your closed caption, so you can see what's going on. Pero no, if you can learn another language, do it, my one, little ones. Eso es bueno. Eso es muy bueno. Okay? So, Betania, tell me, how do you manage to do your work in Opera Memphis, your singing, and also now that you have a family? Because sometimes that's important. Sometimes people don't want to follow some careers because they say, they're going to keep me away from my family. I have to be at work almost all day. How do you balance these two things, family and work?
That's a really good question. I just had a baby 2 months ago, so I'm learning right now how to balance this. But the great thing is that I work for Opera Memphis, and they have been exceptional. They've been very understanding, and I just returned back, and they're so wonderful and have given me patience and grace while I try to figure out how to be a mom and a working person.
Wow. Well, my friends, there it go. Si ustedes han estado pensando, maybe you say, I sing and I want to be an opera singer. Here it is. Betania ya les dio unas cuantas tips de how you be. The first one is you have to study. It's not just sing, you have to study, okay? So, one last thing for the people. Tell us, what will be one of your suggestions if somebody wants to do to be an opera singer? What would be one of your recommendations?
Well, I would probably suggest start listening to opera. See if you like it. Watch opera. Opera is available online now. You know, you can watch so many operas. I would also tell you that you're going to have to work really hard and have a lot of determination. In this field, you can get rejected quite often. So it's very important that you be resilient and you know that eventually you will end up where you're supposed to be. And then, you know, another word of advice would be to remember that you have something unique to say. And your experiences and your thoughts are very worthy of being heard.
Okay. Can you sing a little for Abuelita Tomasa? Algo así cortitito.
A ver. ¿Qué cantaré?
Un pequeñito para que vean. Porque si yo les canto, a lo mejor se duermen o se desmayan. Pero algo así chiquito de ópera. Algo pequeñito. Not too much.
Okay. Tengo el niño durmiendo en el otro cuarto, pero voy a cantar Tita. Okay, no he cantado en mucho tiempo, desde que me embaracé, pero okay.
Okay. ¿Vieron cómo me dejó? Así me dejó, con esa voz. Y si es que ustedes la conocieran, es una muchacha chiquita, menudita, guapa, delgadita, y con esa voz de foda que tiene adentro. ¡Wow! Betania, thank you very much for being here. Gracias, muchísimas gracias. A ver, un mensaje, dinos qué es lo que pasa con Opera Memphis ahorita. Platícanos rapidita para que la gente se interese un poquito más acerca del lugar donde tú trabajas.
Pues ahorita estamos en medio de la pandemia, así que no tenemos shows, pero queremos conocerte. Así que si después de esto ven a alguien con una camisa de Opera 901, no dudes en hablar con nosotros. Queremos conocerte y escuchar y compartir tu historia.
¡Excelente! Y bueno, ella ya nos compartió algo de su historia. Así es que, niños, thank you very much for listening. When I grew up, I want to be. Cuando yo crezca, quiero ser opera singer, como Betania, tal vez algún día. Gracias. Betania, thank you again. Muchas gracias. Y nos vemos en la próxima. Thank you. Bye, niños. Pórtense bien. See you next time. Bye, Betania. Un beso al bebé.
Bye, abuela.